Good afternoon, my dear student. As you know, we shall continue with the chapter of different types of landforms over the Earth's surface. And last year, we already started the different type of mountains, and between them, we discussed about the fold mountain. Now, today, I am going to discuss about the block mountain. What is the block mountain? Block, that is a sentence, that is if we divide these two terms, block and mountain. So, which mountain that is formed into a particular block-wise? This type mountain are known as the block mountain. So these block mountains are very important. So which mountains are formed as a block wise? This type of the mountains are known as the block mountain. Now how these block mountains are formed? That is the main things. Then how the block mountains are formed? So what are the process of the formation of block mountain? At first, before the land masses, the normal land masses is like this. The normal land masses. But sometime during the endogenous process, that some force it create on the inside the earth surface. Otherwise, for the like the earthquakes or this side the reaction when it occurred, endogenous force in the earth surface. That time the from the earth surface, this is the earth surface. This one is about the earth surface. That few part, this earth surface few part is goes upward. This is the earth surface. Before that, the land is like this. Now, few part from the earth surface is goes upward and few portion is goes downward beside the region. And it make that this portion is called the fault. When if the fault it occur, this is called the fault. This fault, due to this fault, the few part of the earth surface is goes upward and few portion of the earth surface is goes downward. This upward portion, which part is goes uplift, or the upliftment portion of the upward portion of the earth surface is known as the block mountain. And beside the block mountain, which portion is goes downward area? This downward lowland area, it's known as the rift valley. What is the name? Rift valley. So again, I repeat, what is a block mountain? That when the earthquake or it's occurred in the inside of the earth surface, that time the few part of the earth surface is uplifted or it goes upward and the few part it goes downward. This upward region of the earth surface is known as the block mountain and the downward region of the earth surface is known as rift valley. So this portion is very important. There is a block mountain and rift valley. Now this block mountain is also known as the host mountain also. And here when the rift valley is a lowland area, so where the at this portion where the this region it goes upwards or downward, this region is known as the fault. Due to the fault only, the few part is goes uplifted and the few part is goes downward. Now these are the this rift valley region is a lowland area. So whenever the rainfall is occurred, that time here the water being stored and this area it formed the rift lake. What is the name? Rift lake. This region it formed the name of the rift lake. So when the water or the rainfall is occurred, that time the rainwater is stored on it and they form the rift lake. So what are the example of the block mountain? That in India is the Satpura mountain. That is example of the block mountain. And all over the world, those are the mountains like the Black Forest in Germany. That is example of the block mountain in according to the world. So these are the different about the block mountain. So I hope you have to understand it. Now the third one mountain, that about the volcanic mountain. What is the volcanic mountain? That when the volcanic eruption is occurred, suppose from a volcano, that when the volcanic eruption is occurred, that time the volcanic lava, it will erupt. That time this from the volcano, all the lava they stored in the over the landmasses area. And they make a triangular type of landform. When all the lavas are stored in over the landmasses area. And when it cools down and they form a triangular type of land surface. This type of the landform, it's known as the volcanic mountain. So what is a volcanic mountain? That when the volcanoes are erupt, that then those are the lavas are start to come out and over the earth surface, it start to cool down and solidify and they make the triangular type landform. This triangular type landmasses is known as the volcanic mountain. Now the example of the volcanic mountains are the Mount Fuji or the others are there, Mount Fuji or Mount Stromli. Okay, these are the different name of the volcanic mountain. Now the volcanoes are the volcanic mountains are the three types. The first is the active volcano, second is the dormant volcano, and the third one is the extinct volcano. What is the name? First is the active volcano, second is the dormant volcano, and the third one is the extinct volcano. Now, these volcanoes are three types. First is the active volcano. That from which volcano that the volcanic eruption is occur constantly, that is called the active volcano. And from which volcano, what is the dormant volcano? From which volcano the volcanic eruption, it's nowadays it not occur at the present situation, but it chance to be erupt. This type of the volcanoes is known as the dormant volcano. So what is the dormant volcano? In which volcano the nowadays or the present there's a volcanic eruption it not occur, but it's in future it chance to be erupt. This type of volcanoes are known as the dormant volcano. And what is the active volcano? In which volcano the volcanic eruption is occur constantly. This type in the present situation also. This type of the volcano is known as the active volcano. And most of the active volcanoes are located at the beside the Pacific Ocean region. And both the beside surrounding of Pacific Ocean. And the third one is the extinct volcano. From those volcanoes are not any chance to be erupt. This type of the volcanic eruption is no chance to be eruption. This type of the volcanoes are known as the extinct type of volcanoes. So I hope you have to understand what is the block mountain and the volcanic mountains and about their formation process. So today, teacher, in my next class, we have to discuss the other types of mountain. Thank you.